Neanderthal fossils are a challenge for consensus. This is so because Neanderthals are a sister group to modern humans, which includes all of us 8 billion actually living modern humans. We have genetic sisters, and that's why we have parents in common with them. Our common ancestors are older than us modern humans, but also older than Neanderthals, Denisovans, and all the phantom sister groups recognized but not yet sequenced. Most likely, Homo erectus will soon become another sister group, which would indicate that our human parents, and consequently, we, are at least 2 million years old. Evidence of modern humans or hominids 1.5 million years old, with clear human characteristics or human genetic influence, has been found and recognized, among others, in Sulawesi. Furthermore, 1 million-year-old modern humans or hominins, with clear human characteristics and human genetic influence, have been found and recognized in China. Furthermore, all 8 billion modern humans are not as genetically alike as most of us think. For example, A. Sub-Saharan Africans do not carry Neanderthal DNA, nor Denisovan DNA. This is presented by consensus as something normal, but it is not because it proves that modern humans existed before Neanderthals and Denisovans diverged from modern humans. Something that clearly predates the consensus-imposed Eve's mitochondrial DNA, which is approximately 200,000 years old. Not to mention that all Neanderthal groups already carried this mitochondrial Eve DNA that supposedly came from Africa, while Neanderthals did not originate in Africa, as they demonstrably originated in the Americas, a fact clearly proven by the haplotype tree of the whole genome, as well as by all ancestral markers. The latter is more of a paradigm shift than an insignificant inconsistency, artifact, or drift. B. Quite on the contrary to sub-Saharan Africans, Australian Aboriginals carry the Neanderthal fraction, plus a high Denisovan fraction. C. Certain Native American populations and certain East Asian populations are in line with the Australian Aboriginals, as they also exhibit high levels of Neanderthal DNA. D. But quite uniquely, certain Native American populations carry specific genetic markers, such as a Neanderthal-derived SLC16A11 gene variant, that are at high frequency in Native American populations, around 50%. E. A newly sequenced Neanderthal genome from Denisova Cave in Siberia contained this Neanderthal-derived SLC16A11 gene variant, which is so characteristic for certain Native American populations, as well as for certain European populations. This exposes a link between modern human Europeans and Native Americans that is much older than mitochondrial Eve. This ancient link can only or best be explained by an expansion from the Americas in the direction of Europe and of Denisova Cave in Siberia, which on its turn, only or best can be explained by a very logical expansion across the dominant ocean circulations, while the Americas are the only continent that is linked with all other continents by both Atlantic and Pacific circulations. But that is one more key piece of information that systematically is negated by consensus, as well as by all alternative historians, that goes on, at least to this moment in time. F. A quite similar expansion is the case for several of the oldest ancestral markers that also are characteristic for certain Native American populations to Oceania and Far East and Southeast Asia. All by all, this shows us that the by consensus very similar supposed modern humans are in fact not at all so similar as consensus tries to make us believe, and at the same time also that genetically we humans are not so different from the now extinct hominins, like for example the Neanderthals, as consensus seems to try to make us believe. The fact that modern humans are morphologically very different from the now extinct hominins, like for example the Neanderthals, this while we genetically are sister groups and genetically quite identical, is something that needs to be explained, and only can be explained by hybridizations and or methylations long before mitochondrial Eve, and at the same time we see some indications of expansions from the Americas to the rest of the world. These expansions to Asia, especially those from the Americas to Asia obviously are yet another challenge for consensus. Further, we provide evidence that Neanderthals A. were not hunter-gatherers. B. did not interbreed neither with Homo sapiens, nor with modern humans. C. were provingly of American origin. D. were deliberately carried across the world by modern humans, this across well-defined, strong and radically defining oceanic circulations. Human history can only be explained when departing from the Americas to the rest of the world. Recently, more and more ancestral markers and other key evidence point out that the Americas are proven to be the place of origin of all humans. As expected, these recent discoveries, although very scientific, obvious, and defining, yet again are not recognized and passed on to the general public by consensus, nor by the alternative historians. This while at the same time, and since much longer, otherwise inexplicable archaeological and ancient cultural facts around the globe can be explained when it is assumed they were spread departing from the Americas, while these cannot be explained when assuming they were not spread from the Americas. For instance, the spread of ancient artifacts as well as ancient cultural facts from the most ancient places in the Americas, like the Andes and the Amazon forest in Peru, etc., to the places outside the Americas, where the Phoenicians provingly had a presence, like for instance, in modern-day countries including Lebanon, Syria, and Israel, where supposed by consensus their civilization originated, but also established colonies and trade networks across the Mediterranean, in countries such as Tunisia, Algeria, Morocco, Spain, Portugal, Italy, Greece, and Cyprus, as well as settlements and contact in places like Sardinia, Sicily, probably Malta, and as far west as the British Isles, can all be explained when it is assumed that the origin lies in the Americas, and that the spreading took place through obvious transoceanic ocean circulations that provingly carry from the here proposed places of origin in the Americas to the here mentioned linked and similar destinations. For instance, the spread of one particular Phoenician-like axe of over 2,000 years old, with a wooden handle with wood from South America, that was found in the most ancient and fortress-like place in the Andes, from the Andes and the Amazon forest in Peru, etc., to the above-mentioned linked and similar places outside the Americas, where as said the Phoenicians provingly had a presence. This while in the here-mentioned cases as well as in many here-not-mentioned cases of enigmatic artifacts and facts supposedly of not American origin, cannot be explained, without the spread to all these places across the world, if not departing from places in South America like Peru and other countries in the Andes and the neighboring Amazon forest. For instance, the spread from certain architecture from the Andes and the Amazon forest in Peru, etc., to the north of Spain, Sardinia, Malta, and even Göbekli Tepe in Turkey can be explained, that is, with spread through the oceanic circulations to the rest of the world. This while the spread from all these many places to the Andes and the neighboring Amazon forest cannot be explained, and this not even by the same spreading through the oceanic circulations, because all these simply do not flow in the direction of the Andes and the neighboring Amazon forest. An example of a typical American ziggurat on a Mediterranean island is the Monte Diacodi site in Sardinia in Italy. This while several examples of American ziggurats are typical for Mesopotamia, and also can be found amongst the oldest pyramids in Egypt. Another example of the mentioned American architecture are the Nuraghi and other ancient megalithic structures unique to Sardinia. Especially the combination of the ocean currents, the ancestral markers, and the ancient axe with a handle from South America can only be explained through American origin of it, because all, and especially the ancestral markers, are scientifically proven to point out the Americas as the place of origin. On top of that, the mummies, ziggurats, as well as the cultures of American origin are the oldest in the world, this by 1,000 or more years. The Carroll civilization in Peru came to an end when the pyramid-building cultures of Egypt and Mesopotamia began. In other words, the Carroll culture emerged roughly 2,000 years earlier than Egypt's pyramids emerged, and flourished roughly 2,000 years earlier than other early civilizations globally emerged. It is obvious that recognizing this would make totally improbable the consensus human history as it is today. We all are aware that the consensus timeline already is drastically challenged by the roughly 12,000-year-old Göbekli Tepe and its whole network of similar places, across the Fertile Crescent. Further, the Fertile Crescent, as well as ancient Mediterranean, that includes the early modern humans' culture of 47,000 to 41,000 years ago, as well as the spatially perfectly associated classic Neanderthal sites, are very well associated with the global expansion through the extended Atlantic and Pacific circulations. This as both depart simultaneously only from the Americas. In fact, the Fertile Crescent is exactly the meeting point of the enigmatic expansions through the extended Atlantic and Pacific circulations, that as said both depart simultaneously only from the Americas. The complexity of Göbekli Tepe as the whole Fertile Crescent challenges traditional theories about the Neolithic Revolution, as it shows evidence of complex construction and organization before the development of agriculture. The Carroll civilization in Peru featured monumental circular enclosures, and these, along with its overall complex architecture, are similar to ancient sites like Göbekli Tepe and other sites worldwide, this due to their age and sophisticated design. Carroll in Peru is known for its large pyramids, residential areas, and sunken circular courts, which are comparable in complexity and ceremonial function to similar structures found in other ancient cultures. Architectural associations further confirm the obvious spread throughout the world. And we are well aware, and much evidence of this is provided in other videos, that it is only possible through the very strong and defining oceanic circulations. These strong and defining oceanic and river circulations are the main reasons that expansion never could be different than departing from the above-mentioned key places in Peru and from the Andes and neighboring Amazon forest, in general towards the also above-mentioned similar places across the world. One so main path is proven to be from Peru and the neighboring Amazon forest to city of Belém in the state of Pará in Brazil, sliding down the immense powerful Amazon River, that will force its waters and all what they contain directly in the also powerful and important and warm Gulf Stream, that in its turn will force its waters into the other currents that will land directly or indirectly on the similar places across the world. To navigate from the similar places across the world to the similar key places in South America is near to impossible, and this certainly without powerful propelling by powerful motors and immense amounts of fuel. This so because first of all the circulation will indeed send back to mainly North Americas, but even if the navigation gets to the very insatiable and confusing Amazon Delta, the Amazon River itself will repel ships trying to enter the Amazon Delta through the Amazon River, and even if the navigation would be able to navigate against the Amazon River, at some point it would be challenged with rapids that need no power to descend, but cannot get upstream without significant power and skills, etc. So any navigation would have to confront ocean circulations, the repelling force of the Amazon River, the flow and rapids of the Amazon River, as well as confront a rise above sea level of 2,000 to 3,000 meters. And on top of that, they would have to confront the organized Amazon Amerinds. Genetically, expansion is only possible from the Americas to the rest of the world. As can be expected, the genetic approach to prove all humans, as well as all hominins, are of American origin is the most decisive approach, but will be explained and proven in other videos. Before we provide all the available evidence further in this video and series, we start out with an introduction. Consensus, as well as most alternative historians, systematically suppresses its increasing number of challenges and its increasing number of paradigms, and consensus does not draw attention to challenges and paradigms, this to say the least. Clearly, that is not the best and most scientific approach. The general public should be made aware, as well as be aware and realize that A. All modern humans, Neanderthals, and Denisovans have an ancestor in common. The whole genome haplotype tree points out this ancestor spread its descendant from the Americas, this starting out with a haplotype B006, that amongst others is also associated with the Neanderthals, which next to the Denisovan obviously are the most ancient that had their DNA sequenced. B. That technically all sister groups carry identical DNA. Leaving the extinct hominins aside, the DNA is so identical that despite differences the general public accepts all living humans as one species, and consensus calls the whole of them Homo sapiens. Differently, the extinct hominins are not called Homo sapiens, yet they have identical DNA. The morphological differences can and must be explained by means of methylations, which are merely epigenetics, and as said, not genetics. With all sister groups having identical DNA, the probability of the ancestor in common not being human is zero. Since pretty much all of these are challenges for consensus, these should raise a lot of questions. Consensus clearly avoids posing or someone posing questions, simply because with its consensus human history, consensus does not know to answer any of them. One of the challenges for consensus is that amongst all three population tests that involve many thousand sequenced DNA, the highest match is between Native Americans and certain Europeans, especially with the French, which is amongst the European countries most exposed to the North Atlantic circulation and by this circulation to the Americas. That means more or less that if someone or something enters the ocean in North America, and even in Central and South America west of the extreme northeast corner of Brazil as well as South America, will end up on the Atlantic facades of the above European countries. Even in Roman times, reports had been made of Native Americans ending up on the Atlantic facades of the above European countries. It seems that there had been this awareness amongst the Romans. In fact, that these Native Americans had come or came across or from Arctic or subarctic regions and currents. On the other hand, archaeological evidence of Phoenician or Carthaginian-like artifacts being found high up the Amazon River as far west as Peru. In fact, ancient North Spain as well as the rest of ancient Mediterranean, and even the much earlier Göbekli Tepe present architectural and cultural similarities with the Chacopoyas in Peru. It further deserves attention that Peru and Chile in the Andes present the oldest mummies and ziggurats in the world. And above all, relevant ancestral markers point to the Americas and more specifically to South America and the Amazon forest. It should be remembered that the Chacopoyas were in close contact with the Amazon Amerindians of the Amazon forest. There are hundreds of proofs that the origin of all humans lies in the Americas, and there is zero evidence the origin of all humans lies in sub-Saharan Africa. The supposed high variability present in sub-Saharan Africa is rather a proof against African origin than that it would be a proof or in favor of African origin. Certainly the Y-DNA of the ancestor of all humans should not present high variability, as it is rather a proof against it being the origin. This is especially so if this same Y-DNA does not spread out of the continent of supposed origin, which in this case of consensus would be Sub-Saharan Africa, which is the case.